Hello guys, it's Darksigner here from the German Duel Masters channel and welcome back to another video. Today we just got a small, quite funny video for you guys. It's not too serious, we want to keep it short and simple because we're in the middle of an IDC weekend where we post the top cut matches of the last week's IDC. But still we wanted to make a bit more content. And today's topic is going to be especially focused around German Duel Masters cards and their translation errors. We had a small like group meeting, of course not in person, and we brainstormed some ideas which cards everyone in the community noticed that have translation errors. And yeah, today I wanted to show you guys something maybe to laugh about, or like if you are from a European country and have your language being translated in Duel Masters. I think the sets 1, 2, 4, 6 and 7 were translated in German, Spanish, French and Portuguese, if I'm right, something like that. So if you have similar things you noticed, feel free to comment down below. And now let's just get started. We start with a minor one that's not really a translation error, but in DM2 the German translation yeah failed a bit because it translated aqua bouncer as aqua wache, because the word wache means guard when you translate it literally, and bouncer is more like, yeah, you know, the bouncer at the club, something that like guards the entrance. So yeah, the word guard made a bit of sense there, but two sets later the card aqua guard came out in DM4, and then yeah, they already used the word for guard in German, so they called it aqua wache again. Just yeah, it's nearly identical, it's just the line in between the words aqua and the guard. And this error was yeah, suggested by Halfa, so thanks for that. I didn't notice that, and yeah, many other community members didn't notice that one as well. It's really just a small funny detail. And yeah, he also told about his early days of Duel Masters, that they weren't quite sure if you can use four copies of each card in your deck. They thought it was like meant to be like that, so like some balancing from Wizards, so that you can only play 2 and 2 or 3 and 1, so you can't play four copies of each of those cards. But of course that's not true, that was just yeah, a misuse of words there. But now let's get into some more serious translation errors. That's still a minor one, but I still think it's pretty funny. So first of all, what you can maybe see in the pictures is that the German card doesn't have a flavor text, but that's something that happened more often. So many times on cards the flavor text didn't have any space left, so they left it out. And sometimes even if there was space, they left it out for some reason. But yeah, what Aqua Surfer reads in English is, when you put this creature into the battle zone, you may choose a creature in the battle zone and return it to its owner's hand. And basically, to translate for you guys what the German Aqua Surfer says, it says, when you put this creature into the battle zone, you can choose a creature in the battle zone and give it back to your opponent's hand. So basically the choosing part stays the same, you can choose any card in the battle zone, but you give it back to your opponent's hand. So it suggests that if you bounce one of your own, it goes to your opponent's hand. So yeah, that's definitely not what the card does, but yeah, just a small little error there. The next one, I think this is the first card that might have a competitive application if the German translation was the right one and not an error, because what Cosmic Nebula says is, whenever you draw the card at the start of your turn, you may draw an extra card. So basically your turn starts, you draw a card from your deck, and with this card on board, you can draw an extra one. But now, pay attention to what the German one says. It says, whenever you draw this card at the beginning of your turn, you can draw another one. So, what this suggests is that if you draw the card Cosmic Nebula and you show it to your opponent, you can draw another card. So, it's basically an upstart goblin for Duel Masters, if you guys are familiar with Yu-Gi-Oh! We thought that one was quite funny, and many decks would tech in four copies of this just to play like a 36 card deck and yeah, thin your deck every time at the beginning of the turn and just use this card as a free blue mana source. So I think this is quite funny. And yeah, this next one isn't really an error and doesn't affect any gameplay stuff, but I still wanted to put this in. It's well-known card, Bronze Arm Tribe. It's translated in German as Bronze Arm Stamm. So the thing here is, the error lies in the name, because what Bronze Arm Tribe is, it's a tribe that has a bronze armor, so like a bronze shield and a bronze lance, sort of. But what the word arm means in German is, it means just the arm from like the body part arm, and not the weapon. So of course, yeah, the weapon stuff from Bronze Arm Tribe is bronze and not the arm, not the limb of the creature. So this is an error in the German language, because arm doesn't have a second meaning. It's just the body part. So yeah, just this small error. It should have been called like something like Bronze Weapon Tribe in German. So Bronze Waffenstamm, if you want the German word there. And yeah, now let's get back to another translation error that had gameplay applications in our early childhood days. I remember this one being misused very much, and I think other community members did that as well. Because what is the issue here with Barquip the Smasher is that it says evolution put one of your on one of your beast folk, and the German translation says put this creature on one of your beasts. So it doesn't specify beast folk, it just says beasts. So what we thought in our early childhood days was that you could play this on any beast card, like also horned beast. So a nice play was that you would play Rumbling Terrorhorn, search for Barquip, and immediately evolve into it. So basically, you had in set two a pseudo speed attacker for 7 mana, so 5 mana for the Terrorhorn and 2 mana for Barquip. So yeah, that was a play that I remember definitely. Something that we didn't get because we had the German cards as kids. And yeah, the next one, Coccolupia, another big one. The English copy says, your creatures that have dragon in the race each cost 2 less to summon, and they can't cost less than 2, and of course dragonauts don't count. That's also what the German card says. But the German card also says, it's not really an error, but it's worded like very poorly, because it says that the summoning of your creatures that include the raised dragon cost 2 or less. And then the second sentence, they can't cost less than 2. But the first sentence says they all cost 2 or less. So basically every dragon in the game being a 2-drop, because of course the second sentence says that it can't cost less than 2. So all dragons become exactly 2 cost. That would be quite broken, I think. And yeah, another favorite, Halfa really likes this card. It's Rumblegate. That has one of the most blatant errors, because the effect is basically the same, but as you can see, it gets plus 2k power. And of course, another difference is that Rumblegate gives 1k power permanently, and the German Rumblegate gives all your creatures plus 2k power attacker. So It got two things wrong. First of all, of course, just the printed power, like the number, and then also it's not a permanent power boost, it's a power attacker on the German version. So yeah, definitely something went really wrong here. And this card was basically way better in the early days, where we just knew the German cards. And yeah, to finish off the video, I wanted to present you the most busted translation error in German Duel Masters, and that is Apocalypse Weiss, because the English version tells you to destroy any number of your opponent's creatures that have total power 8000 or less. So yeah, you all know what the card does, but the German one says destroy any number of creatures your opponent controls with a power that have power 8000 or less. So it doesn't say total power, it just says creatures of your opponent that have power 8000 or less. So basically it's a board wipe for 8k and less creatures. And yeah, if this card would be like legal, it would be so broken. But I think at that point we knew the English cards a bit better, because it was the last set where the cards were translated in DM7, and I think we knew that this was mistranslated, but I'm not too sure. Some people might have gotten that one wrong as well and used it as a complete board wipe for 7 mana. That's quite funny. It's like an all-time running gag in our German community that if you're in a bad spot and nothing can really save you, we say something like, yeah, just play the German APOC and win the game. So yeah, that's something we found very funny. There are still some cards that had minor differences, but not like really translation errors. That's why we didn't show them. But as I said in the beginning of the video, if you have something in another language that you're familiar with, if you're like from France, Italy, Spain, yeah, I think I forgot to mention Italy early on. I think yeah, Italian, Spanish, French and Portuguese cards are also being translated. So if you have some stories like these, feel free to share them down in the comments below. I hope you guys enjoyed this video today. It was a bit different, but yeah, I think it was also quite special, because like all the English speaking countries don't know of these situations and these translation errors. Yeah, feel free to leave your opinion on those down below as well. And until next time, see you guys.